Welcome to rivalgo.com. In this video, we will discuss about very interesting applications which we can integrate it within a Jira instance, and by using that, we can push any of our data into Azure DevOps. So we'll see here practically how we can do it. For performing this activity, you will need to create connections. Connections, it means for integration, you will need to create configurations or do the configurations for Azure secret key, Jira secret key, as well as the configuration pointer for this applications. And here we have to also do the configurations and field mapping for that. So let's understand why and where we can use this. It means the use cases of this add-on or the applications. So first use case is, let's say we have two companies, company A and B, which is working closely together. They have different systems and they need to integrate within the application so that their team members can work it together with the closely. That time we'll utilize this add-on. Second is, we have two departments within one company are using different tools for developer and project manager, or maybe with the DevOps. For collaborating together, we have to install this application within Jira. And third use case is, like, in one company acquired another company, let's say company X acquired company Y, and we want to perform the migrations without losing any data. Here we will use this add-on inside the Jira to have all those information in one place. So let's see how we can add this add-on within our Jira instance to work it efficiently. Now, to install this add-on, we have to navigate into the app sections. From here, just click on explore more app. So once you select this explore new app, more apps, you can just find it out, find new apps, and from here just type Azure DevOps integration with Jira. Simply search for this product and you will find it out, Azure DevOps for Jira integrations and migrations. Once you select this add-on or the application, you will find this page, and here you will have all the descriptions and details are available. This add-on is created by Get Int Organizations, and for trial version, simply select and try for free. This will be available for 30 days, and post that if you want to extend this, probably you have to pay for this. Once you make the payment, you will have this add-on available within your bucket. Generally, at the time of installations or adding within our Jira instance, this will take some time, and once it is done, we can start using this add-on. After that, we have to perform the configurations. For doing the configuration, as I mentioned, we need to create secret key for Azure DevOps as well as for Atlassian account. So till the time this page will open, let me create my API token. I will just rename it Azure DevOps with Jira. Create it, just copy this token ID and paste it to here. So this token ID, we will use it for the configurations. And in Azure DevOps, we also need this token ID. Click on personal token, and from here generate the token. So I'm just writing the name Azure DevOps with Jira. We have to create the full access. Click on create, and we have this token ID generated. We'll use it at the time of configuration. Now here we can see Jira integrations and Azure integrations. We want to use this Jira Azure integrations. So I will select this, and from here, once we'll open this page, Jira with Azure DevOps integrations, here we'll have the complete setup available. So this is our dashboards and integrations and reporting and analysis. But to connect with Jira account or with Azure DevOps account, we have to perform the integrations from beginning. Just click on integration. I want to delete this so that I will configure it in front of you. Now here, this earlier configuration is deleted. I want to delete these two as well. Now to create an integration, we have to just click on create integration. Here we have continuous sync. So whenever we are creating a new task and activity within a Jira account or in Azure DevOps account, if we want to make a sync up, then we are using this tab. And for historical components or for historical information, we'll use migration activity. So let's go ahead with this one, connecting with the sync up. Here, we'll select Jira. From Jira URL, just specify the URL which we want to integrate it with. So just add this URL, click on next. And here, exactly same thing, you have to provide an email ID. So whatever email ID we are using, we will just add it here. And finally, the token ID, which we have just created it now. Now that's done, and you can see connecting with the project. So as of now, I'm just using my company or team manage any of the projects I'll select it. For the customized GQL, that is Jira Query Language, if we want, we can use the GQL for syncing up the detail. So click on connect and we have this integration in place. We have to perform the same thing with Azure DevOps. Here I'll select this, provide the URL. So I will select it here. Just add this URL. Now provide the email ID and the secure token. Click on add and we are okay to proceed. We'll select this project and again, if we want to add the query, we can also connect with the query form. Now this integration is in place. Now, once the configuration is done, let's go ahead with tagging the fields. So let's say this time I wanted to go ahead with the Epic. I want to do the mapping for Epic in Azure DevOps. Here we'll get two options. If we want to add any additional fields, we'll add it from here. But by default, we have title and descriptions. Let's go ahead with this. And after that, we want to add status. So here, we'll go ahead with the status. Like first is backlog. So I'm going to tag backlogs with to do. Let's add it. Then in progress, I want to tag with doing. And then after that, done with done status. So this is done for the status field. After that, we have the comments and attachments. So by default, comments are selected. But if we want to synchronize the attachments, we also have to enable it. In hierarchy tag, we have the epic relations and synchronized subtask relations that if it is required, we can select it. Otherwise, let's proceed it further. Now you can see epic is added successfully. Next time we want to select the bug and here we'll tag with issue. So let me copy the configurations and use this configuration, same configuration here. Apart from that, I will tag again task with task. Exactly same configurations we'll use it. Means we want to just copy the configuration from here and use the same configuration. We don't have to worry about the creation of the configuration again and again. Now, once we are done, let's add the name. So Jira with Azure integrations, specifying the name. Click on create and this integration is successful. Once the integration is successful, we can see in dashboards, reporting sections, and analysis is available. Let's try to create some of the issues. So when we are creating within our project, this time I think I mapped it team managed. Now connection is successfully done. Let's proceed with the creations of the project. So here I want to see the backlog options. So let me move it to my sprint, some of the options. Let's go ahead with the company managed project. Now in company managed project, we have the task defect epic user story. So this time I want to update the title of my task. So here I want to update the title as task updated post integration. We'll use same detail in my description, and apart of that, I also want to add some attachment. So part of attachment, I will select this file, and now I'm done. Let me add for the defect as well. Post integration. Exactly same message. I will copy and paste it to the description. We'll attach some image and save this. Now I'm done with this. So let's go ahead with Azure DevOps. Within the Azure DevOps settings, select the projects, and from the board options, you will see the detail. So before proceeding further, let's check into reporting. Within the reporting, we can see this one is updated. So here, now you can see this task is updated post integrations. So here we can see this task is updated post integrations, and here we'll have the new attachment added. If I want to create one task here, that is also possible. We can create. So I want to add task. So I will just add the title here. This task is added from Azure DevOps. We'll add the same description here. Click on save. Now this task is added successfully. If I want to see it from my Jira board, I will be able to see it. But before that, I want to add one more item. Let me add one epic. Epic from Azure DevOps. We'll add same description here. Click on save, and this is done. So let's refresh this. In the reporting sections, this one is done. Let's wait for the some time till the time we can check the second item. So you can see here, this is also getting updated because this is the defect post integrations. These two fields are getting updated. Now I just wanted to see the result which we have just created, and I want to see the detail into Jira board. So let me refresh this and run. In run options, Jira with Azure integrations, same item 4, and here we have Azure. These two details we have added from Azure. So if I want to see the logs, the proper sub item and async item, everything can I can see it here. Even if I want to see the details, I can select any of the items. In the run sections, we have synced 4 items. Perform things is available here, but I can't see the detail as of now. This was successful. Let's see. Yeah, this task is added from Azure DevOps. I can see it clearly. For this, this got failed. Let's see the reason. To do is tagged with label to do. Project ID I can see, and here we have complete analysis. So this got failed because fetch flow trigger invalid response status. So invalid Jira license sync error, invalid response status code, which we can see that is name is required. We have not provided the name. Customer ID is also not there. That's the reason that got failed. But we have added 2 fields. One is got successful because of the information, wrong informations. We are unable to see the pool. Now, if I want to add one item from here, I will again add it. So I will just tag the bug. This bug is created post integration. Now this is done. It will take some time. So to refresh it within Azure mode, so let's wait for a few seconds and then we will have that defect available. So when we are mapping or clicking three dots, we can copy the configuration. That's the important thing when we wanted to integrate within a board. And app can work fully behind the firewall and we can scale to other applications like ServiceNow, Zendesk, and work, which is more important information. Let's see if we want to perform this type of activity, probably we can use this add-on. Now let's see the integration part. Do we have this data available? We have created this and this was the part of mode creation. Let's refresh this Azure DevOps and we have this bug is created post integrations. So this is how we can provide the single activity. This after integrations will have all those details available within Jira as well as Azure DevOps. So that's all from this. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.